So I have this conversation with one of my followers talking about the RTS and the JB and Singapore and how it will affect Singapore property. And his idea was RTS because it's more convenient, meaning more people can actually travel to JB. And because JB prices are cheaper, so people may start to buy JB and rent JB prices instead of Singapore. And therefore, this will cause Singapore prices to drop. And this is my take on how the RTS will affect Singapore property. Number one, RTS is a train that connects Singapore and JB. It gives you a lot of accessibility, so it's very convenient. Singapore has HDB and private and landed. 13% stay in condo, 7% stay in landed, and 80% stay in HDB. So the 20% in Singapore, right, compared to the whole world, we are one of the richest, in fact, outpacing places like London. Okay, so Singapore has a lot of rich people. And if you are one of the richer people in the world, right, what they like is they value their time more than money, which is why they will unlikely take the RTS to travel all the way there so that they can save there and buy a cheaper property over there because it's cheaper on their pockets. They will focus on making a lot more money so they can save a lot more time. Another thing about rich people is they like flexibility. They like to go as and when, which is why you see a lot of people in Singapore owning cars, even though our public transport is so affordable and so convenient. That's because people with the ability to do so wants the flexibility in their timing. And especially when you are like of the high profile, the top 20% in Singapore, you must understand they value something the most, privacy. Why do you think people stay in condo? They like gated community. They like the privacy. They want to be exclusive. You know what I'm trying to say? Because they work so hard, they want to come back home without being disturbed. I'm pretty sure they wouldn't want to take a train, travel all the way to Johor so that they can stay in a place that has no convenience, not as much as compared to Singapore. So with all these factors, I really don't think RTS will affect Singapore property much. However, I think it will benefit the, you know, lower income or maybe the slightly middle income, certain percentage of them, but not too much. Because if you have the ability to save your time, I believe time is the most important commodity for all of us, regardless whether you are rich or not.